All right.
Here we go. Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Up until this point, we have assumed all changes in electric current, electric potential difference, and charge on capacitor plates were instantaneous. Today, we put a resistor and a capacitor together in an electric circuit and learn how those variables change as functions of time. This is called an RC circuit because it is a resistor and a capacitor in a circuit.
Right.
We start with a circuit composed of an uncharged capacitor, a resistor, and a battery, and an open switch, all connected in series. At time initial, or time equals zero, we close the switch. This is called charging a capacitor through a resistor. Let's start by adding a loop in the direction of current flow in the circuit, which is clockwise. Then let's use Kirchhoff's loop rule starting in the lower right-hand corner of the circuit. Bobby, could you please do that?
Okay, Kirchhoff's loop rule states that the electric potential difference around a loop equals zero. Starting in the lower right-hand corner and moving in the direction of the loop, the first circuit element we come across is the switch. However, after we close the switch, that just acts like any other wire in the circuit, and all the wires have negligible resistance. So next up is the battery. We are moving from the negative to the positive terminal of the battery, so the electric potential goes up as we move in the direction of the loop across the battery, so that is a positive EMF. The next circuit element is the capacitor. Well, as the battery moves charges in the circuit, positive charges will be pushed in the direction of the current, and will build up on the bottom of the plate of the capacitor. And negative charges will be pushed opposite the direction of the current and will build up on the top plate of the capacitor. That means the electric potential will go down as we go across the plates of the capacitor in the direction of the loop. So we subtract the electric potential difference across the capacitor.
I thought negative charge carriers or electrons were really the only thing which moved to cause current in electric circuits.
Sure, that is what is really happening. However, we always work with conventional current, which is the direction positive charges would flow if they were actually moving.
So, do positive charges actually build up on the bottom plate of the capacitor?
Actually, positive charges do not build up on the bottom plate of the capacitor. What actually happens is that electrons are moved off the bottom plate, which causes a net positive charge on the bottom plate. However, this is a good general representation of what occurs and helps to understand RC circuits. So let's keep Bobby's approximation of what is going on here. Bobby?
Okay, next is the resistor. In a previous lesson, we determined that electric potential goes down when moving in the direction of the current across a resistor. So we subtract the electric potential difference across the resistor.
Bo, please substitute equations in for electric potential difference across the capacitor and the resistor.
Sure. We know capacitance equals charge over electric potential difference. So the electric potential difference across the capacitor equals charge over capacitance. And we know Ohm's law states that the electric potential difference across a resistor equals the current through a resistor times the resistance of the resistor.
Thank you, Bo. However, we are going to use a lowercase q for charge because the charge is changing as a function of time. And we are going to use lowercase I for current because the current is also changing as a function of time. So please realize charge q and current I are both changing as functions of time in this Kirchhoff's loop rule equation. Okay, let's look at limits. Starting with time initial equals zero, we stated earlier that we are charging a capacitor through a resistor and that the capacitor starts with zero charge on it. Therefore, the initial charge on the capacitor equals zero. Realize that also means the initial electric potential difference across the capacitor is also zero. You can see that is true from the equation for electric potential difference across the capacitor, which Bo gave us. Billy, please use the loop equation to determine the initial current in the circuit.
Absolutely. From the Kirchhoff's loop rule equation, we know zero equals the EMF across the battery minus, well, the initial charge is zero, so zero divided by the capacitance of the capacitor minus, well, the initial current in the circuit times the resistance of the resistor, that means initial current times resistance equals EMF. So the initial current in the circuit equals the EMF across the battery divided by the resistance of the resistor. Oh, and because the charge of the capacitor will increase as a function of time, electric potential difference across the capacitor will also increase over time. This means the electric potential difference across the resistor will decrease over time, and that means the current in the circuit will decrease as a function of time. In other words, the initial current in the circuit is also the maximum current.
Thank you, Billy. Now, let's look at the limit after a long time. Please realize, after a long time, in the parlance of RC circuits, means you can consider time final to be equal to approximately infinity. Bo, tell me what you know about this RC circuit after a long time, or roughly an infinite amount of time.
Well, the current starts at its maximum value and decreases the entire time, so after a long time, the final current in the circuit is roughly zero. That means the electric potential difference across the resistor also equals zero. You can see that from Ohm's law. Substituting current final of zero into the loop equation shows us that the charge final on the capacitor equals the EMF across the battery times the capacitance of the capacitor. And because we know the charge has been increasing this whole time, we know the charge final on the capacitor is also the maximum charge on the capacitor.
Well done, Bo. Thanks. And thank you for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.